And ma'am, do you understand that this is a negotiated plea, which means that your attorney and I have reached an agreement, or the state has reached an agreement as to the proposed sentence that will be made to the court?
I do.
Do you understand that the recommendation being made to the court as to this accusation on counts 1 through 6, that you be sentenced to 12 months of probation to run consecutive with one another?
I do.
Well, for Trump campaign lawyer Sidney Powell, looks like she's willing to take a plea deal. Big fan of the art of the deal. And this might mean bad news for Donald Trump, who of course is indicted in the very same Georgia election meddling case. Now, Powell is one of the 18 co-defendants in that case. And here's what we know. She's pleading to 6 misdemeanor charges, according to the agreement read in court. But we'll get about 12 months of probation for each count, as well as a $6,000 fine. She'll also have to pay about $2,700 restitution as part of the plea deal. But the big get here is that she will serve no time behind bars. My guess is that is the reason why she took the plea deal. But in order to take the plea deal, you gotta be willing to testify in the case, meaning testify against your co-defendants. So let's get to some of those details. First off, I think it's worth noting what the indictment says. So the indictment lists the charges that she was facing, including conspiracy to commit intentional interference with performance of election duties, conspiracy to commit intentional interference with performance of election duties. So 2 charges of that. Election interference, again and again and again. And it really has to do with her role in basically like breaking into the Coffey County election office and obtaining voting records from the office itself, which is of course a very serious crime. Now here's more on what Sidney Powell was facing in this case and why she likely took the plea deal.
If this case had gone to trial, the state would have shown that on between the dates of December 1st of 2020 and January 7th of 2021, the defendant Sidney Powell, along with several co-conspirators, entered into a conspiracy to intervene with the performance of election duties of co-defendant Misty Hampton, also known as Emily Misty Hayes. At all times relevant to the conspiracy, Misty Hampton was the elections director for Coffey County, Georgia, and was subject to all duties imposed by Chapter 2 of Title 21 of OCGA. The purpose of the conspiracy was to use Misty Hampton's position to unlawfully access secure elections machines in Coffey County, Georgia. This conspiracy included the following objectives. 1, to willfully tamper with electronic ballot markers and tabulating machines. 2, to cause certain members of the conspiracy who were not officers charged by law with the care of ballots and who were not persons entrusted by any such officer with the care of ballots for a purpose required by law to possess official ballots outside of the polling place.
So rather than deal with that trial, she has instead decided, all right, I'll plead guilty to some misdemeanors. She's pleading guilty to 6 counts of conspiracy to commit intentional interference with performance of election duties. And as part of the agreement, Powell must testify truthfully about any co-defendants involved in the case and provide all documents to the district attorney's office relevant to their case against the other co-defendants, according to Fulton County Judge Scott McAfee. So the Trump team is kind of pretending like this is no biggie for them, but I certainly would be concerned.
Yeah, so I hope that as part of the deal, she also has to release the Kraken. I've been waiting this whole time for the Kraken, so I hope she's got that in her back pocket. Okay, so guys, we don't yet know how important this is because of one giant critical fact. We don't know what they talked to the prosecutors and what deal they made behind the scenes. So we know she's getting a super light punishment and is testifying against the others. But if it's about like the one voting machine in Georgia that they broke into, yeah, it's obviously illegal. There should be punishment for it. But that's a tiny thing, if I'm being honest with you guys, right? The real thing, like if that's all they did, I'd say, guys, let's get past this, okay?
Really?
Yeah.
Breaking into voting machines?
Yeah, yeah, and I'll tell you why. I would, don't get me wrong, I'm not gonna let them off. I'd say those guys, whoever they did it, should have faced significant criminal penalties. But that's not a coup attempt, it's one voting machine in Georgia. And it's a bunch of, right-wing guys under Trump, etc. And a bunch of local yahoos going, oh, we got this, okay? But one voting machine isn't gonna make the difference in the whole country. The real deal is the fake electors. So that's an actual coup attempt. Mm. So if she has the goods on how they plan to overturn democracy, if she knows and can help prove that they knew they lost, but were trying to use fake electors to steal the election, then this is the biggest thing that's happened, like in a long time. But if she comes in with some weak sauce about a voting machine, this and they were being mean, that those are that's Jake, then it's a waste of time.
For them to essentially give her a slap on the wrist as part of this plea deal, wouldn't she have to prove that she's got the goods?
Yeah, and so that's why I don't know the conversations that they had. But remember, Anna, prosecutors really, really want to win in general.
And that's true. Yep.
And so now, look, to be fair, Fani Willis has done a great job so far, right? We're very much in favor of how she's handled this case so far. And she's shown courage, she's shown wisdom, etc. So she's earned our trust to some degree. So I'm hoping she got this right. But a lot of prosecutors will be like, oh, I flipped somebody. Yay, me. And she'll testify and she'll say some things that'll help me a little bit. Good enough, mm-hmm. right? And so I hope that Willis hasn't done that. And so she's got to deliver the goods here, guys. And remember this, this was not at all surprising to me. If you watch Young Turks, I told you guys earlier, and we told you guys, that a lot of the co-defendants were flipping on Sidney Powell. They were all pointing their fingers. And so we already knew she was a sacrificial goat, right? So they were gonna throw her under the bus. So at some point she'd have been nuts not to get a deal with the prosecutors.
Well, let me also just note that even before anyone was indicted in this case, well before anyone was indicted, I remember that Sidney Powell in her public appearances just was so unhinged that it even made the Trump campaign uncomfortable with her. So they started distancing themselves with her.
And that's the other reason why they picked her to throw her under the bus.
Smart.
She'll go, hey.
It was smart for her to decide to flip. I mean, it wasn't so smart for the co-conspirators, right? Or co-defendants.
Yeah, so since they did a little bit of distancing from her, they almost had to pick her as the person to sacrifice. So, oh no, she's the one that did everything. None of the rest of us were innocent. She had the Kraken, she had the dumps, she had the mules. It was all her, and that's why we distanced her. But they previewed that already. So, one of the things we found out is it turns out Sidney Powell isn't crazy after all, because to stay on the side that's throwing her under the bus would have been crazy. Like, she would have gone to jail, she would have gotten the most severe sentence, and she would have gotten no support from her co-defendants. Now, she walks away with a deal, and I hope to God, like I said, that it's a good deal that gets us real information. If she gave weak sauce information, then man, she skated, and then that would really bother me.
So we'll see how it plays out, but I did want to also fill you all in on some of the other co-defendants, including the man with the best last name in this entire situation, Mr. Cheesebro, Kenneth Cheesebro, that is. Now he refused to take a plea deal, so he will stand trial. And if he's found guilty, he will deal with the full extent of the punishment that the judge decides. An attorney, he was an attorney. He's facing 7 counts after prosecutors said that he's the one who drafted a strategy to use so-called alternate electors to prevent Joe Biden from receiving the Electoral College votes necessary to basically make his win official. Now, Sidney Powell is the second person who has flipped. She's the second one to do a plea deal. Scott Hall is the other individual. He pleaded guilty to tampering with voting machine equipment. Now, Steve Sado, who is Trump's lead attorney in this case, says, no sweat off my back. He told ABC News, quote, assuming truthful testimony in the Fulton County case, it will be favorable to my overall defense strategy. So he's either putting on a brave face or he means it. It's really hard to tell, but we'll see how it plays out.
Yeah, look, Cheesebro is gonna wind up being pivotal. And it's amusing that the guy who's pivotal in this case is the funniest name in the world. But the reason why is he's one of the principal actors in the fake elector scheme, mm-hmm. right? So if he flips, oh, now ball game, Now Trump's in trouble. Okay, if he doesn't flip, and they throw, since he's going first and way before anyone else, if they throw the book at him, if they convict him and send him to prison for 20 years, you know what's gonna happen to the other 17 that, or 16 that have not cooperated yet with the prosecutors? Like, sweat's gonna go down their face, like all of their hair, makeup, or whatever it was on Rudy's face is gonna flow down their faces. They're gonna be in a cold sweat panic if that brother gets, or that bro gets 20 years in jail, okay? So throw, let's go get Cheese Bro. If he did it, obviously correct through way through the justice system, prove the fake elector scheme, and throw the book at him.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.